Hello and welcome back to my channel. If you're new, my name is Lorey, and in this video I'm going to be going over Taurus Sun with Leo Moon. I'm going to start off the video by talking about what a typical Taurus Sun is like, and then I'm going to get into the Moon placement and talk about it as a combination and how it affects certain things. And so if there's certain aspects of the Taurus Sun description that don't quite resonate with you or don't make sense for the person that you know who has this pairing, then stay tuned until you hear me talk about the Moon placement, and it will probably tie together quite nicely and make a lot of sense. So Taurus Suns are very calm, reliable, consistent, very practical, very sensual and romantic, emotionally stable, patient, but stubborn. They have a lot of perseverance, but they're also very risk averse. So Taurus enjoys feeling good through all of their senses, whether it's tasting and smelling good food, feeling a soft blanket on their skin, gazing at a beautiful sunset, enjoying a hot bath, or even having great sex. Basically, they want to feel good always, and they carve out a routine in order to, you know, have all of their favorite things that they like to do and how they like to spend their time. So they love and they need stability, security, and routine because they're very picky about how they spend their time. Taurus Suns are just very picky about how they spend their time, and because they've carved out a time, like how they like to spend it, and they really enjoy it. And so that's why it's hard for them to, they can end up becoming a bit of a slave to routine because they don't really want to do anything else. So Taurus Suns also really enjoy luxury, material possessions, but they do so practically so as not to risk their financial stability, because being stable is and avoiding risk is one of their, like, they need to do. But so they do enjoy the luxury and the material possessions, but when they do, they're going to make sure that it doesn't, you know, break the bank and that they're not struggling to pay rent and that sort of thing. A Taurus can actually sometimes even view their loved ones as possessions because their loved ones are part of their security, part of their routine and their stability, and so they can actually be a little bit possessive of their people. Tauruses are very patient, but when they are provoked or they feel their possessions or their stability at risk, they are very stubborn and unwavering, and they really dig in their heels. So Tauruses believe in working smarter, not harder. They can be slow to get motivated, needing kind of an extra push compared to maybe some other signs. And Taurus has a bad rap of being lazy. And some of them can be, some people of any sign can be lazy, but Taurus can be lazy. But for the most part, I feel like it's a gross generalization and misunderstanding of the sign. And really what it is that Taurus believes in working smarter, not harder. They want to get the most reward for the least amount of effort. And so they don't dive in head first into projects without first thinking about the smartest way to do it. And they also want to make sure that the reward is worth the effort, because they're very shrewd about how they spend their time and their energy. They're hesitant to spend time on something that takes time away from their routine that they have crafted perfectly because they love doing every part of their routine and it makes it worth it. You know, even if they don't truly love their job, that job provides the money for doing all of the other things that they enjoy doing. And so they've been very crafty about how they've spend their time and what they're doing. And so those one-off projects or starting something completely new that's going to take a lot of time away from that time that they love, you know, it's got to be worth it. There's got to be a really good reward at the end that's worth the effort and the time spent away from what they love doing. And the only time that it's worth it is if the end result is more enjoyable and more desirable than their current life. And it also needs to have a high chance of succeeding and therefore then worth the sacrifice to get there. And so All of this does take time in order for them to assess and figure out the smartest way to do it, if it's worth the time, if it's going to be more desirable at the end, does it have a high chance of succeeding, because they're not about to risk and gamble here. So that does take time in order for them to get started. But if after all of that, they've decided, you know what, this is worth my time. Once they start, they like do not stop until it's done, because once they get started, they always see their endeavors through and they even gain more momentum as they go. It's much like a bull when it begins to charge. It slow to start, but it gains speed the whole time until it's done. So when Taurus people are unevolved, they can be lazy, overly materialistic, possessive and jealous, overly stubborn, as in they never compromise on anything, and they can be very stagnant and stuck in their ways, narrow-minded and a slave to routine. So those are all unevolved aspects of Taurus that could potentially happen. But for the most part, they live in the moment. They love to enjoy spending time doing little mundane things. They take pleasure in boring everyday things. They're pretty easy to please. They can be quite stubborn because they have their way that they like to do things. But they're also a very loving placement and just enjoy life and like to live in the moment. And they also are very hard workers once they've decided it's something that's worth sacrificing their time to. So if you haven't picked up on it already, Taurus is very consistent. They're very reliable. They don't have a lot of mood swings, and that depends on the moon placement. But Taurus in and of itself is a very consistent, very reliable, and very emotionally stable placement. And they tend to stick with what they know, what is familiar to them, and what they know they like, what they know they enjoy. Now, I'll give you an example. My partner is a Taurus moon, and when we order food, she always orders like her go-to things, right? And she rarely branches out. On the rare occasions that she does, she almost like always regrets it and wishes that she had just gotten the thing that she knows she likes and that she gets all the time, because you just stick with what you know. Unless I order something different, and then she'll try some of mine and then she loves it, and then she'll order some like for herself. But pretty much any change that we make is like started by me. Taurus are just really reluctant to change. And like, for example, our apartment, we really needed a new couch, and we also have this kind of empty, we used to have this empty space kind of where the dining room is supposed to be that just looked ugly, wasn't really anything going on there. And so I really wanted to like get a room divider and turn it into a cool little spiritual corner. And I was wanting to do that for months, and I kept being like, we should do it. And she would just, any change I want to make is always met with this like hesitancy and this resistance from her. And so then I realized I just need to go ahead and make the changes, and then she loves it. Like, I got to do whatever I wanted with this office because it's like my space for work, and ended up being her favorite place to hang out when I was done and to do school. So then I was like, well, I can spruce up the rest of the apartment, and I was like, I could do this. And she's just like, I don't know. Like, she just is always met with this like resistance and this hesitancy about it. And so then I realized I just need to go ahead and do it. And so because we also really needed a new couch. Like, there was only one spot to sit on it because it was actually broken, and you're just like sitting in the dip that hits the floor when you sit on it. So I was like, this is ridiculous. Like, I knew if I was like waiting for her, it was going to be a very, very long time. So I like found a couch, we got it, it was delivered, and then she fucking loves the couch so much. And then I went to Home Depot, I got the lumber, and I built like a little wall and table, made cool little spiritual corner, and she fucking loves it. She loves all of it so much. And it was just like, I could have done this months ago. I need to just do it. And then she enjoys it. And it's because it's that hesitancy about change and that not wanting, like, worried about things being different. Cause like, what if it's worse? And not, you know, I have my way, like I have the things that I'm used to. Don't really want to change it. Don't want to rock the boat. It's also about the work involved in doing those things, because those are all one-off projects. And I find that one-off projects are like Taurus kryptonite. Anything that's like a one-off thing, like a doctor's appointment, building that spiritual corner, getting a new couch. I sold my car and I was looking for a new vehicle, and then we had to get the insurance switched over, so I was looking for new insurance. And all of those things, like, I just have to do because like they're just not her jam. Like, it's gonna be a long wait because I'm about speed. Like, I gotta get this done now. I'm getting this done now, like right now, like in a day. I got the spiritual corner done, in a day I got the couch figured out. Like, in the span of a week, I sold my car, I found a new car and sold my car and got the insurance switched over. So like, because I'm an Aries, and that's you can see the difference between the Aries and Taurus is the speed in which they pursue things and what their strengths are. Aries, I'm definitely like about those one-off projects. They make me feel productive. They're done. They're quick. I don't need a whole lot of perseverance with them. Taurus, on the other hand, it's those one-off projects. It's because to them, it's like, well, this is just, it's one and done, but it's just taking this chunk of time out of my day, like out of my routine, and taking times away from the things that I like, creating some sort of change. And it's just not what they enjoy. Like, I almost find that Taurus is better at projects that are long ones, like long ones that they can incorporate incorporate into their routine, because then they can make it something they enjoy and it's consistent, as opposed to just being these one-off things that they do that mess with their schedule. And so if you have like long projects are for some reason better for Taurus. Like last summer, my partner, she's a small engine mechanic, like she would buy mowers and fix them up and then resell them. And she was doing that all summer, and it was a lot of work, and she was doing it after already working on mowers all day. And but she was doing it, she did it all summer, and it's because it was this, like, she incorporated it into her routine. On her lunch break, she looks at mowers. After work, she's picking up the mowers, and then she's fixing them, and then posting, and then in the evening she's posting ads and doing like the bookkeeping and keeping track of everything. So she like incorporated it into her routine, and she loved it, even though that was far more work than the other shit we have to do. That one, she was more motivated because she was able to make a routine around it, and also because it made money instead of spending money. So Taurus are usually kind of resistant to change, and again, this depends on other placements, but Taurus in and of itself is resistant to change. However, they can and do change. It's just a very slow, long process. You know, I'm an Aries and Sagittarius moon, and so for my approach to personal development is very extreme, and it's very inconsistent. So it's more like, you know, I do these big like extravagant things, like I'm gonna go on this retreat in Peru and have this crazy spiritual awakening, and it's gonna be great, right? And then there's Taurus, they would approach it more as like a routine thing. You're like, oh, I'd really like to start making a change in like personal development. I'm gonna start reading 10 minutes a day this personal development book. And they just read every day, and then they'll do it, though, because it's a little change and they're able to work it into their routine. They do it every day, they do it consistently, and the change is probably a lot slower, but the change is probably also a lot more consistent and a lot more reliable when they do make a change. Because a lot of people that, for example, go to those retreats, when they come back into real life, it's their same old life, it's their same habits and their same environment and everything. It's harder to make that long-lasting change when you don't change your environment and you don't change your habits. And that's exactly what Taurus does. So it's slower to get there, but it does get there, and when it does, it's very consistent and it's like firmly rooted change. And so that's one great thing about Taurus, is like even though they are slow to make a change, when they do make a change, it's pretty firmly rooted and very consistent, and they are not the kind of people that would then slip back into old habits, because the whole reason they've made a change is because they started by changing their everyday habits. Now I'm going to get to the moon placement, but before I get started, I wanted to let you know about my free astrology Facebook group called the Astrology Club. I'm really excited about it. So in that group, I post free trainings in there, and I also post transit videos weekly. So every week I'm going over the transits, and then on Subscribestar, I also have weekly horoscopes that you can access for $4 a month. So if you would like to get access to either of these, a link will be in the description. Now we get to Leo moon. Leo moons are very energetic, charismatic, passionate, and they love to be the center of attention. They're quick learners. When it's something they're passionate about, and like most fire signs, it has to be something that they're passionate about, that they're interested in, and then they can pick it up quite quickly. But if they don't care about it, they don't have the time of day for it. Leo moons are also very social. They have a good sense of humor, and they are motivated by status. They like to be like popularity. They want to know that people admire them and like them. They like to have some level of popularity with other people. Leo moons are just, yeah, they're very passionate, very charismatic, boisterous even, and they just have this like zest for life and connecting with other people. They can, if they're healthy, they're usually very generous with their loved ones and will do anything for them, and they wear their heart on their sleeve. Forgot to mention a few key parts about Leo moons as well, is that they really thrive off of compliments and praise and just words of affirmations from the people in their life. That's why they strive for popularity and things, because then they'll get more, you know, praise and words of affirmation and things like that. Leo moons really do thrive off of the praise of their loved ones, and in some cases that can be a problem if it is the only source of confidence that they have. I feel like some Leo moons can fall in this trap where they're so overly reliant on other people's praise and compliments that they don't have a whole lot of confidence outside of that. They don't have this internal source of confidence. And when that happens, if they don't have this internal source of confidence, and then they're not getting the praise from the people around them and compliments and things like that, that's when they can start to feel really insecure and then try to overcompensate and slip into that arrogance and narcissism that is the stereotypical generalization that Leo has a lot about them. But that usually happens, you know, when they're unevolved, when they don't have this confidence outside of other people in their life. And then if on top of that, they don't have a solid support system around them. But if they have a healthy support system and they have people in their life that love them, that they know love them, and then they also have some kind of source of internal confidence outside of that, then that's good. And they're just a very confident, outspoken person who has a very assured sense of identity. And then they're far less likely to slip into that arrogance and narcissism that Leo can sometimes fall into. So Leo and Taurus are square each other, so they're quite different. Leo is, you know, out there doing all the things, and Taurus is more like wanting to do their little routine. And Leo moon has like big dreams and big goals and is very exuberant and is very broad-minded. They're actually quite open-minded, but Taurus is more like, this is the thing that I like to do and ain't no one stopping me. It could be difficult for them to kind of like strike a balance between the big goals and the passion that Leo moon has and the Taurus moon kind of, Taurus. But much like the Taurus Sun Aries combination, if they're able to strike a balance, it's kind of Leo moon will be the good push that Taurus needs in order to not stay stuck in a rut, not stay stuck in a routine, and actually achieve more, strive for more, and dream for more. And it's kind of that initial push that Taurus will need to then get started. And then Taurus is really good about seeing through the projects that they finish and will get them there. And this is someone who would probably do really well at work, or whether they start their own business. Moving up the ladder, I feel like the Leo moon would really help them connect with people and be a people person and have that more like bigger presence they need in order to be noticed and move up the ladder and, you know, be a good leader. But now a goal that would serve both of these placements is anything that would provide some sort of status as well as financial gain. In that case, I feel like both of these placements would be like, fuck yeah, let's do this, because you've got, you know, you get kind of that status and that popularity that Leo wants, that feeling of achievement and admiration. And then you get the money that helps make all the material possessions build for Taurus. And I don't even mean like in a bad way. People say materialistic. I think it's fine to be materialistic. We all are to some degree. So I just don't want people to think I mean that in a bad way. Like, I like my material shit. Thank you so much for watching. That's all for today's video. I hope you enjoyed this. Stay tuned for more content, more sun moon combinations. If you have anything else that you would like me to make videos on or you would like to learn, leave a comment below in the description. I will also be having a survey fairly soon. I'm hoping in the next couple weeks to find out what people would like to learn, and I might be making a course on that subject. And if you would like more content and like to learn more, the Astrology Club Facebook group, I'll leave a link in the description for that, as well as Subscribestar. You can get access to weekly horoscopes for just $4 a month. That's all for now. Take care.